Hey folks, this is Beyond the Songs with Blue Water Highway, where we perform an original song and then we cover a song that is related to it or inspired it. This time we got something extra special for you we haven't done before, so sit back and enjoy.
Oh,
All right, that was Council Grove, track 8 off of our new album, Paper Airplane. Show him, Greg.
Oh, here we go.
Here he goes. Look at that. Fancy. And what you just watched was something from...
Part of, yeah.
Yeah, something special we got coming at you in November, on November 18th. That was from the Fire Station Studio Sessions. Fire Station is a studio in San Marcos that we love. We went in there with a lot of our friends, who filmmakers we worked with in the past, and filmed the entire album. Surprise!
And tracked it all live, yeah.
And tracked it all live. So we have a show for you. It's going to be the entire record from start to finish, live, in studio, professionally filmed and recorded. And we just can't wait to get it out. So you saw the first clip. First glimpse of that in our song Council Grove. It's going to come around the same time as a lot of stuff we got cooking in October, November. Maybe a new song. Who knows?
Maybe.
Also, yes.
They don't tell me anything.
You were there. You forgot. Also, we have a deluxe edition of Paper Airplanes coming out. It's going to have some songs from these Fire Station sessions on it, along with a new song. And we just are super stoked for y'all to hear it.
And the Fire Station sessions are going to be broadcasting on Noon Chorus, which is a streaming service. We're super excited about it, on November 18th. So put that date in your calendar.
Flash it on the screen.
Flash it on the screen.
November 18th.
We're really excited about it.
November 18th.
Yeah, if you saw the video that Kyle's been working hard editing these videos, he mentioned we went into the studio with a bunch of our friends to record and film it, but this guy's been editing all the video, so it's going to be awesome. We're really, really excited about it.
If you become editing this.
If you become a Patreon subscriber, you can go see another song, a preview of another one of those songs from that session. Yeah. Right now, all you got to do is go to our Patreon and become a
version.
Subscriber.
That's another exciting thing about doing this. You know, it's not just us doing the song again. Sometimes we took a little bit of a different take, and that's always what's exciting. You know, as a band that plays live, you change it up. And I think with me and the Electric Man especially, we took a different take on that one. So you can see that on our Patreon right now.
Yes, indeed. Okay, so Council Grove. What does that mean, Greg?
What does that mean? What are those random two words?
It's
put
like
together?
A.
It's like China Grove
of druids, right? Is that what it
right.
is?
Right. This is a song about like druids.
Druids. Is that what it meant? I always
no. 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 The reason ridiculous.
The reason Zach's directing that question towards me is because Council Grove. Is my father's hometown, and I still have some family back in Kansas. Yeah, Council Grove, Kansas, which is where my father grew up. And it's a place I spent a lot of summers, you know, as a kid, visiting family, going out to the lake and, you know, sailing, swimming, fishing, hanging out, visiting that side of the family. Small little town in the Flint Hills of Kansas. And so that song came about after we visited once on tour. We stayed there and drove through the Flint Hills, and when we got back to Texas, Zach was pretty inspired, I think, by just
the magical
place up there that you know.
Well, growing up like in high school down, you know, on the Gulf Coast where Greg and I grew up, I would go over to his house and they had this picture of the Flint Hills of Kansas. Mm-hmm. And to me, it didn't look anything like Kansas, because my only experience with Kansas was the Wizard of Oz and you know,
cornfields flat.
Yeah, right. But this was the Flint Hills, and it was like a picture that's shrouded in mist, and it was beautiful green pasture land that looked kind of wacky, like something you see on planet Earth, where you're like, oh, that doesn't exist anywhere in the world, but it does.
Yeah.
So when we drove through there, it really is like God's own pasture land.
Yeah.
It's like this crazy green.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's really pretty.
It's a really pretty spot. Kind of like almost like Ireland hills. Like
it really did
like
remind me kind of like that.
Irish hills.
I didn't know that existed
something.
In America.
Yeah.
In fact, we got some footage and made a lyric video for Council Grove that you can actually see what we're talking about.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But no,
we
go
found
ahead.
Well, I was going to say, we found that video, just found a video of the Flint Hills on YouTube and contacted the guy that had filmed it. And he let us use his footage for the lyric video.
Well, it turns out he was a music teacher.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
So he, it was especially meaningful to him. He's so like, cool. That's so cool. Yeah. I love the song.
It was really awesome.
So thus, the song was born, when, and Council Grove kind of became this metaphor for nostalgia, you know, kind of those places.
Yeah.
Places or things or past events or whatever that live larger than life in your mind, and, you know,
right.
to reconcile the present and the past and the, right. you know,
escaping,
everything in between.
Escaping to an idyllic place.
Yeah.
With that, but realizing that nostalgia is like a grammar lesson. Present tense, past perfect. Right?
Nice.
There you go.
And the truth is that it's not perfect. In the past, everybody's got work to do in their own time, and that's the message of the song in that journey of that character. So.
But also what's funny about that song is that it's a song about Greg's family's hometown, but you sing it.
Yes. Yeah. Well, you know.
No, it's cool. I've thought that's something that's cool about it.
Yeah.
Totally.
We, you know.
To that point,
we
of like how we associate this tune with Greg and Kansas and all these things, mainly the Greg part, not the Kansas part. We were beckoned to, for this next tune, to do something also that I always associate with Greg, which is the band U2.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Wait, U2?
U2. You stole my joke. I was going to totally throw it in later. Come on. Only one of us could do it.
You can still throw it in later.
All right, Greg, what are we doing? What's this next song?
So I'm going to sing a U2 song, Beautiful Day, which is, you know, one of their big ones. But I think it's, I've always really enjoyed singing the song just because kind of have a little more, you know, folksy vibe with it and kind of make it less, you know, arena rock.
Arena rock.
Your version has always been like this.
Yeah, so.
And it's always been really compelling.
Yeah, I've been covering it for a while. So we're going to bring you Beautiful Day by U2 and
one of Greg's favorite bands.
Yeah, one of my favorite bands.
And it did inspire, I mean, it's a band that's inspired our band in general.
Absolutely. Oh yeah, for
atmospheric
sure.
stuff you're doing on your guitar, writing,
well,
everything.
In Council Grove, this song is like, well, especially live, but I mean, it's the most rocking song on our record pretty much, you know. So it kind of fits
anthemic,
yeah, with that U2, you know, vibe of their arena rock stuff.
Yeah. There's also a, I would say, a direct lyrical connection too. There's a bridge of this song. He just goes all around the. It's a really cool bridge. All around the world, seeing the life. I don't know. It reminds me of life. Like it's just
activities of humans.
Tuna
doing
fields.
Different
the,
things.
Yeah, activities.
And, yeah.
The Bedouin fires at night.
Right.
And I thought, man, what? There's a thing they do in Council Grove to preserve the. Explain that. It's preserve the pasture land.
Yeah, right. I think it's like a way to rejuvenate the soil. They burn the fields in the every fall, right? And helps the nutrients, you know, reinvigorate the soil for the next season and stuff. So
driving through there,
if you go at the right time, like a right time of year, they'll burn all the fields, and it'll just be You'll see signs like when you're driving up there too, like, you know, warning. Burn the fields. Or
just
whatever,
epic. Burning pasture.
Yeah.
That's so cool. Mm-hmm. So that's used at the end of the song, inspired by the U2 bridge, to is a real thing that happens in Council Grove,
right,
to show that like rejuvenation.
Yeah.
You know?
Absolutely.
Renewed purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And both these songs really do like put you in the place, like you're set the scene, you're like driving, you know, into the driving through the Flint Hills and stuff. Like Beautiful Days kind of got that, you know, setting the scene for, like, it's like a great driving song too, I feel like, you know, driving in your car on a
sunny day.
Sunny, you know, perfect 70 degree weather day, whenever that happens.
Mm.
Roll the windows down.
Not in Texas. It's not right now. Okay, I have important questions. Whatever silliness y'all keep talking
you too?
About. We said we could only do it once. Come on, man. What is The Edge's real name? Does he have a real name? Or is that his name?
And if you don't know, The Edge is the guitar player for
U2.
Is it The, or is it just Edge?
It might just be Edge. Yeah, it's a great question.
Oh, he's just an Edge. He's not
he's
The
just edge.
Edge.
It's just Edge. Just like it's edge. Just Bono, right? It's like Edge. Bono.
Oh, he's
like
just
The Bono.
A Bono? He's not The Bono?
As far as I understand.
And the other guys, they just didn't show up to the
Bono.
Meeting where they came up with cool-ass names?
Nope.
They just...
Bass like player, what is it, Larry Mullen and Adam
and
Clayton? Is that
Meanwhile, it's The Bono and The Edge.
Yep.
Where does Bono come from? Do we know that?
I don't know. I don't know the answer
what
to that.
What about Edge?
Tell us if you know.
Tell us if you know. I'm Edge, sure there's somebody out there like that
knows. I probably knew at one point.
Don't they come from Ireland?
Yeah, probably knew at one point because I did read a biography or two, but it's, you know, there's only so much you can keep up here on that trivia stuff.
True.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, he has a real name.
Well, now I'm thinking we need names.
What would you, what would you be, too late. Kyle?
What would I be? Can I name myself?
Can you be Doc, or is that not as cool as Edge?
It's been taken. It's got to be.
We'll get back with you next time.
It's important. We're not signing off till we get a name. You need a name too.
How about you guys go in the comments and you tell us what would be Kyle's name
mine?
Or all of our names?
Oh, wait. Oh, I got to inspire them. So
In true U2 fashion, only two of us get names.
Yeah,
so two of us get names and the other two don't. Is this where animation happens? What's happening?
No, I'm just like posing.
Who needs animation when you have this kind of entertainment?
This is important.
Comment below. What's Kyle's stage name?
Okay.
He's posing for us.
No, okay. So anyway. Anyway.
That should be enough. I can't give you too much. If you want more poses, go to our Patreon.
Yeah. And don't forget.
Bam.
I think you're talking about a different website.
Oh, sorry.
Anyways, if you want to see the show, we've got Via Noon Chorus. It's on November 18th. We love y'all. This has been Beyond the Songs. And this is about to be a beautiful day.
Heart is a bloom, shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck. The reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck. You're not moving anywhere. You thought you'd found a friend. Get you out of this place, someone you can lend a hand. In return for beautiful day, the sky falls, you feel like a beautiful day. Don't let it get away. You're on the road, you got no destination. You're in the mud, in the maze of her imagination. You love this town. Touch me.
Hey folks, thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, like this video, and comment down below.